introduce Dash. This is our fire engine. Up at the front, this is where we sit. The firefighters sit up here. The driver drives. Back here, we've got a big pump that pumps all of our water, goes to the fire, puts it out. Up on top, in case we ever need to get on top of a roof, we can use these ladders. And then in the back of this fire engine, we have a bunch of tools. I'll show you one of them. That's a chainsaw, pretty dangerous, but we know how to use those. It's pretty big. If it's coming down the road, you got to get out of the way, right?
Hey, Waymakers. Today's story is found in Daniel chapter 3. I'm going to read verses 1 through 18. King Nebuchadnezzar made a golden statue 90 feet high and 9 feet wide and set it up on the plain of Dura in the province of Babylon. Then he sent messages to all the princes, governors, captains, judges, treasurers, counselors, sheriffs, and rulers of all the provinces of his empire to come to the dedication of his statue. When they had all arrived and were standing before the monument, a herald shouted out, "O people of all nations and languages, this is the king's command. When the band strikes up, you are to fall flat on the ground to worship King Nebuchadnezzar's golden statue. Anyone who refuses to obey will immediately be thrown into a flaming furnace." So, when the band began to play, everyone, whatever his nation, language, or religion, fell to the ground and worshiped the statue. But some officials went to the king and accused some of the Jews of refusing to worship. "Your Majesty," they said to him, "you made a law that everyone must fall down and worship the golden statue when the band begins to play, and that anyone who refuses will be thrown into a flaming furnace. But there were some Jews out there, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, whom you have put in charge of Babylonian affairs, who have denied you, refusing to serve your gods or to worship the golden statue you set up." Then Nebuchadnezzar, in a terrible rage, ordered Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to be brought in before him. "Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego," he asked, "that you are refusing to serve my gods or to worship the golden statue I set up? I'll give you one more chance. When the music plays, if you fall down and worship the statue, all will be well. But if you refuse, you will be thrown into a flaming furnace within the hour. And what god can deliver you out of my hands then?" Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego replied, "O Nebuchadnezzar, we are not worried about what will happen to us. If we are thrown into the flaming furnace, our God is able to deliver us, and he will deliver us out of your hand, your majesty. But if he doesn't, please understand, sir, that even then we will never under any circumstance serve your gods or worship the golden statue you have erected." So, what do you think King Nebi will do to them? A. Give them another chance. B. Lose his temper and throw them into the fire, or C, he has a temper tantrum and cries a lot.
Thank you.
no. I just got a text from Mr. Mustache. The fireman just rescued him. He needs our help. We better hurry. Mr. Mustache!
Get as far away from that fire as you can, and you're going to call 911.
Great answer, thank you. So what happens if my clothes catch on fire?
So that's actually another good question, real important one too. So the first thing, you have to remain calm. And what we do is we tell the kids to stop what they're doing, they drop to the floor, they cover their face, and they roll. And so to demonstrate this stop, drop, and roll, Firefighter Diego is going to show us what to do in the event that your clothing ever catches on fire. Firefighter Diego, your clothes are on fire. What are you going to do? No, we don't want to run around. We want to stop what we're doing. We want to cover our face, drop to the ground, all the way down, lay down, and we're going to roll. And then come back this way. And we're gonna do that until the fire's out. All right, good job. All right, Mr. Mustache, are you ready to try this? Okay, your clothes are on fire. What are you gonna do? Yeah, down, cover face, and roll. He's gonna roll, good. Come back this way, Mr. Mustache. Okay, good, and the fire's out. Good job. That's another great question. We get that a lot. One of the things that we recommend is a smoke detector. It's required by law, but a smoke detector in every room, every floor, and you have to also make sure that they work. And that's something that your parents can do.
So why did you decide to become a firefighter?
Well, the number one reason I did was I wanted to help people like Mr. Mustache that happened today. I wanted to be able to give something back to my community, and that was local. And that's why I became a firefighter.
Thank you so much for answering those questions. For rescuing my friend, Mr. Mustache. You're so very grateful to you guys. All of them. Thank you. And throw them into the fire. Hey, Mr. Mustache, I think I have something in the picnic basket that might make you feel better. Let me look. Where did it go? Ah! Will that help a little bit? Might cheer you up. Let's see if there's anything else. But if he doesn't, please understand, sir, that even then we will never under any circumstance serve your gods or worship the golden statue you have erected. Then Nebuchadnezzar was filled with fury, and his face became dark with anger at Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He commanded that the furnace be heated up 7 times hotter than usual, and called for some of the strongest men of his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and throw them into the fire. So they bound them tight with ropes and threw them into the furnace fully clothed. And because the king, in his anger, had demanded such a hot fire in the furnace, the flames leaped out and killed the soldiers as they threw them in. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego fell down, bound into the roaring flames. But suddenly, as he was watching, Nebuchadnezzar jumped up in amazement and exclaimed to his advisors, "Didn't we throw three men into the furnace?" "Yes," they said, "we did indeed, your majesty." "Well, look," Nebuchadnezzar shouted, "I see four men, unbound, walking around in the fire, and they aren't even hurt by the flames. And the fourth looks like a god." Question: who was in the fire with them? A. An angel. B. Ronald McDonald. Or C. Jesus. Hey! Oh! Hey! Oh! How's it going?
It's going alright. I was just in the area. Thought I'd swing by the clubhouse and see what was going on. Anything cool?
Well, we had a little bit of a problem with Mr. Mustache and the firemen, but thankfully the firemen were there to be able to help him, and now we're just kind of...
Did they put out Mr. Mustache?
No. They rescued him.
Oh, he wasn't on fire. Okay. It just seems like something Mr. Mustache would do.
Thankfully not.
So is there anything fun going on?
Well, actually, if you'd like to sing a song with us...
Sure. I don't have any instruments with me, though.
Oh, you know what? I'm gonna look at my picnic basket.
Okay.
I think I have something we can use. Would this work? It gives us a little bit of a beat.
Let's see what we can do.
Okay. So the song we're gonna sing is Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Never heard it. But I'll play this to the best of my ability. You can sing it.
Okay.
Okay.
So it's kind of a fun one, kind of a silly one.
Okay, I'll do my very best. That's what my mommy always said.
Okay.
All right.
Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, Abednego, Abednego. They went out down to the world above. They worshipped him alone. The king has been thrown into the flames, into the flames, into the flames. The king has been thrown into the flames. Worship God alone. God sent his angels to rescue them, rescue them, rescue them. God sent his angels to rescue them, and they were not harmed at all. The king said, "Praise be to their God, to their God, to their God." The king said, "Praise be to their God, save them from the flames."
Wow! This is a pretty cool instrument.
There's a lot of instruments.
Can I take this home and practice?
Sure.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
That in my collection. Well, that was a lot of fun, but I do have to be going now, and I'm going to take this box, and I'm going to be the best little box shaker there ever was.
Okay.
Well, I better run. My mommy's making macaroni and cheese tonight, which is my second best favorite other than pepperoni pizza.
Yum.
So... sometimes I put macaroni on pepperoni pizza if we're having leftovers. Like on Thursday, I'll get my macaroni and I'll put it on the pizza and mix it in. And but it's bad if you have leftover night from like Taco Tuesday and you have like fish tacos and you have the pizza. And I don't recommend that whatsoever. That might be gross, fish tacos.
No.
But anyway, I'm going to take this box, practice it. If you ever need anybody to come and play with you, let me know.
All right.
Okay?
Hey! Oh! Hey! Oh!
Oh! Before I forget, when I was walking up here, I noticed your mailbox. The mailman was delivering something, so I just took it so I could bring it up to you.
Thank you very much.
Yes. And Mr. Mustache, it was good seeing you. I hope you get better. I know you have probably a traumatic time being rescued. My cat got rescued one time, and he just laid up on the windowsill for at least probably a week and a half, and so... stay away from the window seals. Okay. I'll see you guys later.
Who's this letter for? Oh, it's for you, Mr. Mustache. You want to come read it with me? It says, "Dear Mr. Mustache, how do you talk to God if you can't speak?" From Waymaker Tatum. Good answer. Thank you, Waymaker Tatum. Waymakers, if you want to send us a letter next week, our address is right here. So we We'll get your letters in our clubhouse mailbox and read them next time. Well, here's your letter, Miss and Ms. Dash. That was nice. Okay. All right. Well, we'll see you later. Bye, Mr. and Ms. Dash. I'm glad you're feeling better. Okay, so the question to the answer was C, Jesus. Verses 25 through 30 says, "Well, look," Nebuchadnezzar shouted, "I see four men unbound walking around in the fire, and they aren't even hurt by the flames, and the fourth looks like a god." Then Nebuchadnezzar came as close as he could to the open door of the flaming furnace and yelled, "Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God, come out, come here." So they stepped out of the fire. Then Nebuchadnezzar said, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, for he sent his angel to deliver his trusting servants when they defied the king's commandment and were willing to die rather than serve or worship any god except their own. Therefore, I make this decree that any person of any nation, language, or religion who speaks a word against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be torn limb from limb and his house knocked into a heap of rubble, for no other god can do what this one does." Then the king gave promotions to Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego so that they prospered greatly in their province of Babylon. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were playing with fire when they stood up against King Nebuchadnezzar. When they didn't bow down to his idols, his statue, they were making a statement. They were standing firm in their belief. They were showing their love and obedience for their God, our God. They didn't bow down to any other idols, any other gods. And because of that, King Nebuchadnezzar got mad, threw them into the fire. But you know what? Their strong faith stood out and was a witness to King Nebuchadnezzar. And God used that time to perform a great miracle and protect them from the flames. He was there with them through it all. He protected them. And because of that, everybody began to believe in our God and worship him. And King Nebuchadnezzar turned his life around. So even if we are standing up against somebody or standing firm in our beliefs, we could be playing with fire. But God is there with us through it all. We need to remember to stand firm on our faith and on our God who loves us tremendously.